it seems like a dream. Roderick Roman just finished high school. Soon he will start college. Not just any college, the U.S. Air Force Academy. He'll do his best. He'll be among the best. Roderick Roman is about to become a cadet. Sure seems like a dream. Hello everyone, I'm Gary Shapiro. Each year, thousands of people drive by here on I-25. They know it's the U.S. Air Force Academy. They've seen pictures of the beautiful chapel and heard about the great football team. But most of us don't really know what this place is like. Who comes here? What are they like when they leave? Each year, some 15,000 young men and women try to get in. Only about 1,400 make it. They're picked by congressmen, and for the most part, they're the best and the brightest. For the next hour, we'll show you what they're up against, why some make it and some don't, and why for most this is a very special university, Wild Blue U.
She's loud and proud.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The history of the Air Force Academy is relatively short. Noting the need, President Eisenhower signed the Academy Bill into law in 1954. The first cadet was sworn in a year later, but the Academy wasn't yet in Colorado Springs. Lowry Air Base in Denver was its home, another chapter in Lowry's colorful history, just the beginning for the Academy. After a lot of soul-searching, politicking, and agonizing, the spring site was chosen. Pilot Charles Lindbergh flew test flights over the area himself. Construction started in 57. By 58, cadets were undergoing basic training here. The most famous building, the $3 million chapel, was built in 1961. It was controversial and funding was held up by Congress for some time. When asked what the 17 spires represent, one officer said, the 12 apostles and five members of the Appropriations Committee. One of the most historic moments at the Air Force Academy came in 1976. The school officially became co-ed and Julie Richards walked under the famous and somewhat ironic sign. The rest, as they say, is history. The U.S. Air Force Academy is now one of the top universities in the country, a monument to those who built it and those who make it fly. For the cadets, it all starts the first day.
Bring them on in here and they can say their goodbyes, but what
happens? All the worries, frustrations, all the work, all the play. All the dreams. But first, you gotta get through the first day.
Lauren, I love you.
Love you too.
Aren't we gonna get out and give him a hug?
I can't.
Give you a hug right here. Goodbye.
Can't get out.
Love you guys.
I love you.
Bye bye, Lauren.
See you later.
I love you, Lauren.
See you later, Amanda.
Right here, basic cadet. You are now a basic cadet of the United States Air Force Academy. Welcome to the Academy.
Love you.
You need something, let me know.
All right.
Bye-bye.
You got a big day ahead of you. Hope you got a good night's sleep because you got a big day.
He's leaving home today. I mean, it's not like going to college.
He's leaving. He'll be back. Just a visit.
Let's go, basic cadets, right here. Before they cross the line, we have mothers and children, kind of a tearful kind of goodbye thing.
Well, you take care, all right?
We take them as soon as they cross our rope. They become our cadets, and we transition them right away. They're no longer civilians holding on to their mamas. They're now cadets at the Air Force Academy, and it's our job to make sure that they successfully transition in that fashion. Let's go, basics. Come on. We need to have a little motivation demonstrated here. Y'all should be very happy to be here. Y'all are a very select few.
Yes, sir.
Sound off.
Sound off.
Yes, sound off now. You know what that means? Be loud and proud.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Loud, 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 loud. Twice as loud.
Yes, sir.
Now twice louder than that.
Yes, sir.
All right, way to go.
If you have anything to say, you'll say, sir, may I ask you a question? Sir, may I make a statement? You probably don't have anything important enough for us to listen to.
Stand up straight. Look like you're proud. Look like you're happy to be here, but get the smile off your face. Look at the back of the head. Now listen to him. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
When I'm talking to you, you can look at me. Look, look, look. Now sound off. Sound off like I'm standing over there by that tree.
Yes, sir.
All right, that sounds good. Have a good day.
We have to establish discipline right away because discipline is the key to being in the military.
For work, hurt. Left, your left, your left, right, left, 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 right. Your left, Your left, right. Your left, right.
How would you like to have it cut?
All off.
All off. We can't not do that. I'm sorry. Well, watching this one right here, I don't think you have, but some of them have tears in their eyes coming running down. Where's your home, son?
New Hampshire.
Well, he's back there where it waters all the time and rains all the time, and hell, you couldn't tell if he had tears or not.
Your day last, you know?
I have no idea.
They look like a man in the Air Force. Hell, they don't look like a hippie.
Looking forward to getting this first day over with.
Yeah.
Basic. Keep walking until someone tells you to stop. Stay, get up early, and you stay here late. We've been here about 8. We'll stay until 8 or 9. Basic. Keep walking until someone tells you to stop. 9.5 in both.
What's this day like? Busy. Because I have to see about 1,400 of these guys and have to give them all hats. Size your flight cap.
7 5/8.
7 5/8?
Whew, you got a big head.
How's that? Snug too loose too tight.
Your left, your left, your left, right.
Basics, listen up. From now on, when you say yes, sir, say it loud and proud.
I think after a whole year of going through this, you become anesthetized to it, and you begin to try to learn what lessons upperclassmen are teaching you through their yelling.
You happy to be here?
Yes, sir.
You feel good?
Yes, sir.
Let's go.
Your left, right. Your left, your left, right. Your left.
Work and sweat, more than I have ever known. Why do I do it? To prove to myself I can. That's what faces these dualies at Jack's Valley.
You.
They are new recruits called dualies. Barely able to find their way around, they march off to basic training. Some end up asking themselves, what am I doing here?
Hurry up, basics! Hurry up, if you're sitting down, you're wrong! Let's go, basics, hurry up!
It's not like any other college. These freshmen start the school year in basic training. Sleeping in tents in the foothills. Welcome to Jack's Valley.
Do proper facing movement, E-bat.
Yes, sir.
Get your elbows, E-bat.
Yes, sir.
Get your shoulders back and down.
Fall
yes,
in.
Sir.
Get your chin in.
Yes, sir.
Sound off.
Yes, sir.
Move out.
Word. Word.
Yes, sir.
We love Jack's Valley.
The sun rises, so does the flag.
No, sir.
And if you do, what are you supposed to do?
Sir, I'm supposed to party myself.
Did you?
No, sir.
Why?
No excuse, sir.
How come?
Sir, I was not thinking.
They teach you to think here, to obey, to reach into your soul and bring out things you didn't know were there. It looks strange to civilians, eating breakfast at attention, constantly getting chewed out, with upperclassmen doing the chewing.
Forehead back. You have a renewed duty concept?
Yes, sir!
Gonna do well today?
Yes, sir!
Carry on.
Yes, sir!
Cook.
Yes, sir.
What's the response to carry on?
Sir, there is no response to carry on.
Carry on.
Get down to the ground. Come on. That's it. Work it. Get down to the ground. Get down to the ground. Get him. Gotta go down to the ground to get out of here.
I need 2 unassisted and 5 with assistance.
If you take everything day by day, it's not a hard day. But when you realize that you got to get up at 6 o'clock the next morning and go over the same things again and again, that just gets tough, you know. You don't know how long you want to take it, and you don't know if you can do the 6 weeks, and it seems like it's 6 years.
They test physical strength. Test agility. Test desire. Some basics have more than others.
Come on, mister, quit feeling sorry for yourself. Climb up that rope.
Basic, come on.
Do not let the rope beat you, mister. Do not let that rope beat you.
Come on,
Randy,
push yourself.
But for those who passed the test, now that's something to smile about.
We like to party.
We like to party.
They try to simulate war here, although nothing really can.
It's pretty much a character builder. Through a lot of stress, physical, mental. Teach them how to deal with it.
Miss, get down. Get down on your knee.
Sometimes there are tears, usually wiped away, to reveal a look of determination. It's basic to basic training.
Move it, get over here! Your butt down, tack position.
Do what I have a weapon in both hands. Move on your elbows, let's go!
Get down! Hold the wall. Keep your head in the dirt, your head sideways, move!
Basic, you better be moving out! Hurry up!
Do you not know how to buckle a football helmet?
No, sir.
Probably never came within a playing field in your life, did you, Mr. Runny?
Fuck her, sir.
Nintendo don't have nothing like this, big boy.
One's up. Let's go, one of these!
In pugel stick training, old football helmets give protection, but it can still hurt.
What is this?
Both hands.
What is this?
I don't know. What is this?
Oh! Yes! Wait!
Better talk first, bro. Are these the 2 feet?
Yes, it's like no other university, but it is a way to teach a lesson. That experience is not what happens to you, but rather what you do with what happens to you. Look past all the yelling, the strife, and the sweat, and you'll find a school where grades must be met. Up next, it's off to class.
You're listening to 104.5 KAFA-FM.
KAFA Campus Radio. Not really what you'd expect at the Air Force Academy. It's a chance for the cadets to get away from the military mindset, if only for a while.
Wells, get over here. Get your knees. You are not putting out. Let's go, get your knees up! You move any slower, somebody's gonna put you people in the ground! Let's go, get your knees up! Get them up, get them up, get them up! Higher! Higher! Higher!
soon and is back to reality. Recognition week signals the coming of the end of the freshman year. It's kind of a hell week with a mess.
Why are you looking at over there? What's so interesting over there in the
bushes? Sir, there's nothing.
What are you backing up for? Are you afraid of me, mister?
No, sir.
Mister, you better not touch me.
The trick is just to remember what it was like for you and, you know, to keep that in mind when you're doing it. Because it's easy to go too far to a point where it's no longer fun for anybody. I mean, this part's a lot of fun.
Let's go, get your knees up, get them up, get them up, get them up. Hi, fellas.
To many, this is hazing, and it's uncalled for. The Air Force calls it something else.
We're trying to get hazing out of here. Hazing's not appropriate. What we want to do with our military training is instill a sense of discipline, a sense of camaraderie, and a sense of working as a team.
Class, cinch hut. Sir, class, what's ready for instruction?
Very good. Take your seats.
Possibly the biggest challenge, however, is in the classroom. Students average 21 hours of coursework each semester. They're shoehorned in between military and flight training and athletics. And students have to keep up at least a 2.0 grade point, or they're out.
It's just stressful, man, because you're always making a sacrifice somewhere.
You always have to, put something else off so you can get something that needs to be done immediately done.
About one-third of the freshmen don't make it for one reason or another. They wash out. The rest survive, but it's not easy.
I get up at around 5:30 in the morning and probably won't go to bed till 11 or 11:30. And in that time, I've gotten to, you know, maybe 6 hours of classes, got yelled at for an hour, had about 3 hours of intercollegiate practice, and then gone back to my room about 8 o'clock at night and tried to study for 3 hours to, you know, get ready for my next day classes. And it always seems like you're trying to catch up.
When you're looking at Dien Bien Phu, you have to look at...
The cadets are tired. They're often fatigued. They're always stretched in many directions at once.
Dr. William Heiser is a civilian professor on loan from the University of Tennessee. Demands on students, he says, takes its toll in more ways than one.
When all your time is accounted for, you don't have a chance to work out those emotional and developmental sides that are also important. And so to a certain extent, the maturity of the cadets doesn't come along as fast as it otherwise would in a civilian setting.
Look at how the flow...
The main compensating factor, Heiser says, is that the cadets are extremely intelligent and very motivated. They thrive on pressure. There have been 28 Rhodes Scholars. Many grads are awarded scholarships and fellowships, and many become future leaders, both in the military and out.
If you're concerned about the public professions, and I am, and concerned about the military profession, then there's something really important that says, I want to have a hand in the development of those young minds. That may be responsible for the lives of my grandchildren.
So those four P9 probes come through these tubes.
The curriculum ranges from aeronautics and engineering to the humanities.
Okay, what angle of attack are you all going to be running at?
For the cadets, it's exciting.
Get your knees up, get them up, get them up, get them up!
And exhausting. It's stimulating and exhausting. It's rewarding and it's exhausting. They sleep when they can, and once in a while, there's time for some fun in their dorm rooms.
All right, ready?
I see a red door and I want it painted black.
They are, after all, under the tough military exterior, college kids.
I see the girls go by dressed in their summer clothes.
They're young men and women, not that much different from students anywhere.
Let's go! Get your knees up! Get them up! Get them up! Get them up! Hi, fellas!
Keeping the Falcons flying means feeding them. No small task. That's why, as the cadets are marching off to lunch, the cooks are hurriedly finishing it.
Forward! March, march, dismiss!
Mitchell Hall, the mess hall, a room bigger than 1.5 acres. 4,500 cadets eat here 3 times a day. Meals take 20 minutes in and out. 400 staff members get them ready, spending almost $7 million annually. And it's home cooking. Well, sort of.
If one of the cadets' mothers or fathers has a favorite recipe, they send it in to us. We can plug that recipe for 8 or 12 into our computer and expand it to a batch size of 4,500 or 5,000.
We're being served steak. Definitely not typical.
Well, this meal's pretty good today. That's probably why they served it to you. Now they knew you guys were coming, and they figured we'd better show a good meal.
It's pretty good for how much they got cooked, I guess. It depends. Sometimes some meals are really bad and some meals are really good, just like anywhere else.
Tacos, stuff like that, they don't really get the authentic type of meal here. They try, but...
But it's not easy cooking for 4,000, yet the job gets done day in and day out. Only rarely do the cadets fail to get a hot meal.
We've had power outages in the middle of our meals, and we've had recipes that have failed either because of human error or planning. And when that happens, you hate to see the food wasted, but you never want to put a bad product out on the table. And so we do have backups. There's always peanut butter and jelly.
And it seems just as the meal has started, it's over, leaving only a giant pile of food scraps and dirty dishes. For the kitchen crew, another mission accomplished. Lord, guard, and guide the men who fly through great spaces of sky. Be with them traversing the air in darkening storms or sunshine fair. It is a place of the third dimension, where the shackles that bind us to earth let them climb higher and faster through the clouds and wind, where a student of flight can explore the heavens and learn of the mission.
Well, flying, it seems like you're finally getting into the real Air Force, or you know, what you came here originally to do.
Lieutenant Hunt.
All right, good morning, everybody.
This is where the mission begins. After 3 years of classroom study, it's time for the cadets to discover their wings.
Today, if you just follow the 3 steps, maintain aircraft control, analyze the situation, and take proper action, that will take you through the EP, okay? So this concludes the formal brief. Fly safe.
Here, they find out it's not the seat-of-the-pants stuff many have dreamed of. It is flying by the book. It's the Air Force way.
What I find it makes you a better pilot. It really does. It makes you more precise, more exact, more demanding of yourself and your aircraft than just going out and screwing around at a civilian airfield anywhere else.
Okay, Dave, your aircraft.
Aircraft? Roger, your aircraft.
Hour after hour, it is a scene repeated. A quarter of a million times a year, planes roll down these taxiways. Students heading out to fly in a very busy classroom.
All aircraft, Academy, I'll turn out 3017, 3017.
Academy Tower, Talon 40, take off. Just number one.
Talon 40, clear for takeoff, winds 1304.
Talon 40, clear for takeoff, clear for takeoff.
Roger. Rally 15 base.
Rather 15, you number 2, precedings a full stop. Wind calm.
Tail base number 1, wind 340 at 4.
Strike 75, wind calm, clear to land.
They are in many ways like traffic cops.
There's times though when we have pattern work that's 6 to 8 aircraft at once, sometimes 10. That's the most we can have in a pattern at any given time. Other than that, it's just a repetition. Round and around they go, and where they stop, nobody knows.
Tower 40 base.
Tunnel 40, wind calm, clear for touch and go.
These controllers not only maintain order in the busiest tower in the Air Force, they also watch over the rookie flyers.
What we're actually looking for up here is safety of flight.
Yeah, Roger, hold short of the entrance, I'll have one coming out.
Somehow it all works out.
Tunnel 40, number 2, clear touch and go, wind 1804.
This is a 20 flap glide path. Notice a little steeper than the no flap glide path. It's pretty challenging stuff out here.
For many cadets, flying is not just part of their schoolwork, it is part of their life. It's the culmination of a dream, the end of a lifelong ambition, the start of a lifelong profession.
Flying is a challenge all in itself, and it's another way to add on to the challenges you already have, but it's also what makes it all worth it. You realize, yeah, there's something, you know, in a year from now I'm gonna be flying jets, and I like doing it.
The first time you drive is a lot of fun, but the first time you fly is totally different. You got that third dimension you're flying in. I mean, you can control everything.
It is in flight that the cadet learns the ultimate lesson, that control of the third dimension is the mission of the Air Force, to defend and protect the heavens, letting freedom fall to Earth. Everyone at the Academy is an athlete. It's required. Some take part in intramurals, others in intercollegiate athletics. But by far the biggest and best show on campus comes on Saturday afternoons in the fall. It's game day at the Air Force Academy. The locker room is quiet and full of tension. Colorful scars from flight squadrons around the country adorn the lockers. Players get taped up and psyched up. Sometimes music helps.
What are you listening to?
Oh, tape I made myself, a whole bunch of stuff. Just a little Motley Crue.
Of the 36th season of collegiate football at the Air Force Academy. This is the Air Force Academy Sports Network.
Hey, birds, it's showtime. Let's go to work.
For Falcon football coach Fisher DeBerry, it's all about winning. It's also about teamwork, trust, and faith.
Let's grab a hand. We pray as we go out and play today, Father, that nobody will be seriously injured on either team. We pray that you will teach us the lessons of life that you would have us to know, to help us be better leaders and better people. And we pray in everything that we say and do in the way in which we pray today, Lord, because we know that you'll be dissatisfied unless we give it our all.
His job is to motivate, to get them to play better than they think they can.
3 o'clock. By gosh, I expect them to hate they ever showed up in Falcon Stadium, because they're going to get a butt kicking. They're going to get a butt kicking. If we're going to make it happen in 1991, it all starts today. There ain't no letting up now. We've gone too far, men. Let's go for 4 in a row. Let's make it happen, son!
It's a different mood in the stadium. The opponent is Weber State. The fans expect a blowout.
Hey, let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
We are ready to go. 1991 season. Here is the run-up, and we are underway. Driving end-over-end kick deep in the end zone. Jones grabs it 8 yards deep.
Let's go, let's go. Let's get it out of the neck now. Let's play hard. Let's play hard. Let's go. Let's go. Let's play hard. Let's go. Let's go.
First down play. Perez running left with the ball. Has some running room to the 25 and is out to the 30 and out to the 32-yard line.
What is he seeing on goal line? Coach, that backer's so wide. If we hit 12, 13 goal line, it's over.
Keeps it himself, cuts inside, down to the 5, touchdown! Now Perez kept it himself.
That's the way!
That's the way! Good drive, good drive, good drive, good drive, good drive, good effort!
When the Falcons score, the cadets do push-ups in the end zone. 7 points, 7 push-ups. 50 points, 50 push-ups.
Looks like we're doing a lot of push-ups today.
He's gonna go! Touchdown! Antoine Banks!
Sometimes a uniform carries pictures of a cadet's two best friends. Why do they do this?
We're made to. No.
Because we're dedicated to the cause of Falcon football. That's why. And we all like push-ups.
Air Force football.
And we're made to. May I have the cheerleader after you, please? We're doing a better job tackling than that. That's horse crap. Third down, Bake. Let's go, Rod. Third down. Let's go.
Here is the handoff to the running back, Lindert, and he is inside the five and battles his way.
That's just like Army. That is stupid.
Let's go, Air Force.
You're smarter than that, Chris.
Come on, CC. Get a pick, CC.
You're never going to make a play on the line of scrimmage with it third down and less than a half a damn yard that deep in the field.
And Perez will run the option to the right and pitch the ball to Wayne Young. Cuts inside over the 50.
Down we die, spouting a flame from under.
There he goes, the 40, the 35, the 30, down to the 20, the 15, the 10, and touchdown!
Hey, nothing will stop the USA.
Good job. That's the way to bounce back. Good job.
We're not training professional football players. We're training the future leadership of our Air Force. And, you know, certainly for something to come up like it did last year in Operation Desert Storm and see all of our guys go over there and perform so well. And I had so many letters from so many of them saying that, you know, some of the experiences that they had in football here and the games that they had on Saturday, a lot of those experiences helped them, you know, be prepared. There's a special young man that's here, and that's what makes it special about coaching here, because I think they understand that there's a lot of high expectations whenever you play in Falcon football.
It's what everyone looks forward to, what everyone strives for. Some say it's like removing a yoke from around your neck. It's graduation day. Shined and ready. It's the graduation parade. It's a show for all to enjoy. It's how memories are made. The sun almost always shines on graduation day. Maybe it's God's way of saying, way to go, cadets. You've earned it.
Having been appointed a second lieutenant.
A second lieutenant in the United States Air Force.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
Support or defend.
Inside the famous chapel and all around the campus, the graduates get sworn in.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
The short ceremony is conducted by friends and family, picked by the cadets themselves. It's a way for many to thank their parents for all the support.
It's a great feeling to just have your parents here to share the culminating point of 4 years of hard work. I mean, they were the support on the home front for this battle. So help me God.
With the words comes Second Lieutenant's bars, a commission, and a new commitment. The end of school is near. The beginning of military life is just ahead.
How do they like it so far?
Comme vous les états unis.
Extraordinaire.
Finally, graduation. Falcon Stadium is packed. A day full of expectation and pride. The cadets are proud of their accomplishments. Their friends and family are proud they made it. Just ask Nettie Wheeler of Memphis. One of her 10 kids is about to become a graduate, and the whole family flew in to take part.
It's feel wonderful. It's so wonderful. I just thank God that I'm here, and I love it. I love the people, and I know Mona do.
The Wheeler family is very close. They celebrate each other's accomplishments. They share each other's pain. Today, they're celebrating.
They help each other. They love each other. They support each other. I taught them that.
We're just extremely proud of her not stopping. And if there's anything to highlight on, it's her ability to always strive and finish the job.
I have thanked God that we have come this far.
Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 1991.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Bush.
This graduation features President Bush and pomp and circumstance to the max. His being here means a lot to the grads, the spectators, and those waiting their turn.
It is an honor for me to join you here at Wild Blue U, the home of the quick and the brave.
He speaks from the heart. Almost 1,000 grads listen, among them, Mona Wheeler.
This magnificent team.
Nettie and the rest of Mona's family listen too. But the words seem to drag on. It's Mona they want to see up there, shaking the president's hand.
Oh, my heart is pounding.
Brian Michael Newberry.
One by one, the cadets get their chance.
This is it.
We have to take pictures.
Yes, this is it.
Mona Dion Wheeler.
Joseph
Corey
Linden
II.
Tommy Lee Peasley.
What has happened? Been a long wait. It really has.
4 years of work, 4 years of frustration. In a moment, turns to jubilation. What these cadets have gone through could never really be understood by the rest of us. Let's just say they'll miss the Air Force Academy, but they can't wait to put it behind them.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are dismissed.
I'm the happiest man in the world.
No doubt.
Mona Wheeler and her classmates are graduates. Nothing left to do now but find Mom and tell her.
I love you. That I was blessed with a mother like her.
I'm happy and I'm happy. That's all I can say right now.
These falcons are ready to spread their wings and fly. Now that graduation's over, things are peaceful. There's time to reflect back. back to where it all started.
Forward, march!
Back to the days when you didn't think you'd make it.
You are now members of the United States military. The pride begins now.
Back to the days that you were glad you did. Each cadet has his or her own reason for coming here, for staying here, for making this such an important part of their life.
I needed something to discipline myself a little bit more. I needed something almost to take care of myself a little bit more, but that I could pay back later, that I could do on my own, and that when I finished, I could look around and say, I did it. Thanks, Mom and Dad, but this one was mine.
It's a bonding here that I don't think there is at a normal college, and you can really count on people here. And I think more than anything you get out of this place is the friends you make, and you know that they'll always be by you.
I've grown up a lot in the 4 years, and that's what the undergraduate college is all about, I think, and this place forces you to do that, and that's what I needed.
This place makes you proud. It makes you honest. It's a requirement. There's a code that cadets live by. It's their code of conduct. We will not lie, steal, or cheat, nor tolerate among us anyone who does.
Yes, sir!
It's their promise to the nation, a promise they'll keep long after they leave.
A lot of people say, well, it's a free education, right? No, it's not. It's a 5-year loan that you pay back, and sometimes even more.
When school's over, things are quiet. There's time to reflect and to look to the future.
Mission objectives, want to fly smart, have fun, and obviously learn something. Airspace restrictions, basically you're subsonic all day today. So go straight to task formation behind me. Don't drop a bomb on something that you're not cleared on. Rejoin after the last strafe pass or the last bombing pass. By then we should be out of gas. We'll rejoin battle damage check and bring three back to initial.
Michael McGinty flies fighter jets for a living. Like all Academy grads, he had to serve 5 years after school. McGinty decided to stay a little longer.
Things I'm looking for here is just make sure I don't have any leaks. Brakes look good, tires are good. Then go up here, make sure the firing leads all look good. I got good ammo in the guns. I got the gun set where I want to fire it. Make sure all the bombs are on secure.
He puts his life on the line every day. He wouldn't have it any other way.
When I was in eighth grade, I decided this is what I wanted to do, and I set my sights on the academy, make sure I get into pilot training and get into fighters, and it's my life. I love it.
It's been a long time since McGinty's Air Force Academy days, but what he learned there goes with him. It is a part of him. Knowledge guides these pilots through the sky. It also guides them through life. That's how the Air Force Academy leaves its mark. On television, we can only give you a sample of life here at the Air Force Academy. Showing everything the cadets go through would be impossible. Yet everything taken together is what makes this place special. It's what makes the cadets special. Only those who go through it can really understand it. Yet we hope you've enjoyed our look at Wild Blue U. A former Secretary of the Air Force once said, "This academy is built on a solid foundation, with a bridge to the future, on a road to peace." That's what this place is all about.